Hello, it's Angus here at the Bureau of Meteorology with the latest on ex-tropical cyclone Jasper. I say ex-tropical cyclone because it has been reclassified as a tropical low. However, when Jasper crossed the coast of Queensland just north of Port Douglas around 9 o'clock on Wednesday evening, it was a Category 2 tropical cyclone, and since then we have seen widespread heavy rainfall, flooding and damaging wind. There is more severe weather on the cards for the rest of today and much of Friday, and that's what we're here to focus on, the severe weather which is still to come as Jasper crosses North Queensland. First thing we'll look at is rainfall, which has fallen last night and this morning, and we can see fairly extensive yellow signals here in our radar showing the regions of heavy rain which have just been driving onto the coastline, really bringing up those rainfall numbers. Top tallies that we've seen so far exceed 500 millimetres about parts of the Daintree area, with a number of other spots along this coast between Cooktown and Cardwell tallying between 200 and 400 millimetres of rain in the past 24 hours. That has led to extensive flooding, and there's also been some really strong wind in this region. But it's not over yet, and let's take a look at why. If we look at the next 36 hours between the middle of the day Thursday and the end of the day on Friday, we're going to see that Jasper, which is represented by this L on the map here, just moves really, really slowly across the north of Queensland. It takes that full 36-hour period for Jasper to move from the central part of the peninsula out towards the Gulf, probably reaching Gulf waters late Friday night or maybe early on Saturday morning. Across that 36-hour period, we expect more or less uninterrupted rainfall across the north tropical coast of Queensland, as well as around much of the peninsula area here through inland places too. With this further incoming persistent rain, we have maintained this broad severe weather warning. Right through this yellow area from about Innisfail northwards, we could see heavy to locally intense rain through the rest of the day Thursday and much of the day on Friday as well. And with the wind still wrapping into that low pressure system, likely to see a continuation of damaging wind gusts, which could bring down further trees and power lines and could cause further damage to property. With all of this incoming rainfall, no surprise really to see flooding across northern parts of Queensland. Here's a snapshot of the current flood situation for these northern rivers, with two rivers currently in major flooding, including the Daintree River here in the north and the Barron River here, which affects parts of Cairns. Other rivers have minor to moderate flooding currently, but we could see further rivers added to this. All across the north of Queensland, we have flood watches through all of these purple areas here. Flood watches are regions that we're tracking closely, monitoring how that rain falls across the catchment, how the river responds to that, and any of these places could see flood warnings issued if the rivers rise rapidly enough. So this is a dynamic and evolving situation. If you're in the north or you know people that are, share this information with them, and don't forget you can always find the latest severe weather information and flood information at the Bureau website. Do check out the app as well, and we will keep these updates headed your way through our social media channels.